Good day, dear students. We are now at Polynomials, Chapter 6. In this video, we will be covering the second subtopic 6.2, Remainder Theorem, Factor Theorem, and Zeros of Polynomials. Let's look at our learning outcome for this subtopic. At the end of the lesson, students should be able to relate the remainder and factor theorem to solve problems. Okay, students, now let's look at example 13. Given that 2x plus 1 is a factor of polynomial px, which is 2x cubed plus px squared minus 5, find the values of p. Since they have already given us that 2x plus 1 is a factor, we can say that when we substitute negative 1 over 2 into the polynomial, we should be getting 0. So what happens when we substitute negative 1 over 2 into the polynomial? So this will become 2 times negative 1 over 2 to the power of 3 plus p times negative 1 over 2 to the power of 2 minus 5. So we're going to simplify this, and we know p of negative 1 over 2 is 0. And 2 times negative 1 over 2 to the power of 3 will be giving us negative 2 over 8. P times negative 1 over 2 to the power of 2 will be giving us P over 4 minus 5. When we try to find P, we will be getting 21. Okay, students. So we attempt to answer this question by using the factor theorem. So for example 14, the polynomial 2x cubed plus ax squared plus bx plus 8 has a factor x minus 1 and gives a remainder of 50 when divided by x minus 3. Determine a and b. So they have given us polynomial 2x cubed plus ax squared plus bx plus 8. And they have given us information that x minus 1 is a factor. If x minus 1 is a factor, we must know when we substitute 1 into the polynomial, we will be getting remainder 0. And the second information given here is the remainder is 50 when divided by x minus 3, which means when we substitute p of 3, we will be getting remainder 50. Now we need to find A and B. So we're going to use the given information and we're going to try to substitute into our polynomial. So first, we start with P of 1. So we will be getting 2 plus A plus B plus 8. And we know P of 1 is 0. So we will be getting 10 plus A plus B, or A plus B is negative 10, is equation number 1. Now equation number 2, we're going to get it from the second information where P of 3 equals to 50. So we're going to substitute P of 3 into the polynomial. 2 times 3 cubed plus A times 3 square plus B times 3 plus 8. So 2 times 3 cubed. So P of 3 is 50, and 2 times 3 cubed, we will be getting 54. 3 squared times A, we will be getting 9A plus 3B plus 8. So we can simplify this to 3A plus B equals to negative 4, which is your equation 2. So we're going to solve equation 1 and equation 2 simultaneously. So A plus B is negative 10. 3A plus B is negative 4. So when we try to solve this equation simultaneously, we will take equation 2 minus with equation 1, which will be giving us 2A equals to 6. So from here, we will be getting the value of A is 3. Next, we're going to substitute the value of 3 into equation 1. So 3 plus B equals to negative 10. and we will be getting the value of b negative 13. So we managed to determine the value of a and b by using the factor theorem and also the remainder theorem. So students, I hope you have achieved our learning outcome, which is relate the remainder and the factor theorem. That's all for this video. Thank you, students.